Coming up on this episode, I talk about trying again, how persistence breaks resistance, and how simply sticking with something is more often than not how it succeeds. It's very rarely on something's first attempt that it's successful. So let's get into it. What's going on, beautiful people? This is the Perspective Chasers podcast, and I'm your host, John. On this episode, I want to talk about trying again. Now, ironically, I've probably tried about 100 times to record this episode now. For one reason or another, life just keeps intervening. But it is a lesson in itself in perseverance. Somebody once told me, persistence breaks resistance. And it really is true. So we push on. No matter what, we try again. No matter what happens in life, no matter what's going to come up, I'm always going to get back up and try again. I really try not to fall into song lyrics. But the thing is that it's always going to happen. There's always going to be things in life that knock you off track, that push you off here, that derail this. Life goes that way, you go this way. It's always going to happen. It's inevitable. So the more resilient you can become, the more accustomed to just rolling with the tide and rolling with the punches you can become, the better it is going to be for you. The easier you're going to learn to handle things, and the better it's going to be in the long run. Now, it's not to say it's going to be easy, don't get me wrong, I'm pulling my bloody hair out at the minute. But it's not to say I won't get it done. It's not to say that I won't push through, and I might moan about it, I might grit my teeth and kick and scream along the way. But I'll put in the work and I'll get it done. No matter what it is, if I set my mind to it, I know I'll get it done. And it is that case of trying again. No matter how many times it takes me to try it, I will get back up and do it. Because if it's worth pursuing, it's worth pursuing. Like, there are things that in life that you're gonna face, and you're gonna go, it's not worth the energy anymore. And fair enough. But everything in life is gonna need that assessment. Everything in life is going to have that kind of value scale to you. Is it worth you putting in the effort anymore, or is it worth you giving up on? And for me, a lot of life is still worth putting in the effort. Don't get me wrong, there are things where I'm just like, I really don't have the energy or time right now. But that's life. Like, we've only got so much of ourselves to distribute. So you have to understand when you can try in each aspect. Like, it's hard to pursue a social circle and business at the exact same time, because one or both of them take up a fair bit of time, especially when you add in family life and this, that, and everything else. So understanding, like, the ebb and flow of your time and when you can try as well, that's the big thing. Like, there's not always going to be the opportunity for you to try. No matter what it is, sometimes you're going to have to bench an idea. Sometimes it's just not its time, or it's not your time. And that's okay. But it doesn't mean that you're not going to pick that up down the line and try again. Whatever it is, like, there's that, it's like an idea of gone but not forgotten. Like, everything has its time and has its place. So being able to see when something has its time or has its place, that is a very innate skill. A video comes to mind of a father and son, where it's like an old dad, and they need this really strange wooden shaped part, and he has like a eureka moment and runs down into the basement and dusts off a box and finds this really weird shape, and it's the perfect piece. Kind of like that. Some may say hoarder's mentality, but I say right thing, right time. So understanding when you can kind of shelve an idea and say, like, okay, cool, it's not its time right now. Like, I've got a few ideas on the back burner right now, which I'm just like, yeah, they're just not ready yet, or I'm not ready yet. It doesn't mean that they're forgotten about. I'll pick them up another time down the road, and I'll push on with them then. Not everything's time is now. But if you have something that you're pursuing, if you have something that you are in the now with, that you are currently pursuing, understanding that if you've hit a wall or if you've hit a plateau, that you will get over it. You just have to have that persistence. Like, everything moves in life, nothing is stagnant. And if we're constantly battling one problem, it's easy to go blind to it. Like, you start getting tunnel vision, you start looking down this single channel of sight, and it's just coming away from something and giving yourself that time to reset and just literally letting your mind detox from the problem or completely recenter on something else and then come back to the problem with a new light. Like, just having that time away really can give you that reset that you need to look at it from a new angle and let go of kind of any preconceptions that you had beforehand, because sometimes they're what's holding us up. Sometimes the solution lies in doing something completely different, but you're not going to see that unless you go away from it and then come back to it and try again. I've said it before, but so I can be like a dog with a bone with a problem. So being able to walk away from something and say, okay, it's not its time, maybe give it a little while or maybe think on it or whatever else, then it's its time. Like, it takes a while to learn that. Like, especially if you're impatient, which I can be. It takes time to understand that everything has its time and has its place. So you've just got to have that persistence to keep trying to see where things fit. Most things don't happen on their first attempt. Like, take WD-40 for an example. Like, it's called that because it was its 40th attempt that was successful. But we don't realize that in the immediate. Like, we just like, yeah, that's WD-40. That's just what it's called. But it's right there on the tin. It says it took 40 attempts to get there. But we overlook that and we just see a product that works. But how many times are we overlooking that in ourselves? How many times are we overlooking the attempts that need to happen for us to be a working product? It's going to happen all throughout life. So look to see those times where you just need to keep trying to get through, to get to your successful, whatever it is. Just put in that effort and keep on trying. I'm going to wrap this episode up because I'm really tired for time today and it's been a hectic couple of days. Like I said, it's taken me a lot of attempts to get this one done. But the seed for this episode is going to be, don't take criticism from somebody you wouldn't take advice from. So if you don't respect their opinion to begin with, why are you going to respect their criticisms of you? I think that's something we could all learn a lot from. If you don't respect somebody's opinion, don't respect their criticism. It's fairly easy, but in such a sensitive world, so many people are getting offended over this, that, and everything else that really and truly, it's all just words and hippity-hoobla. Right? There's no need to be so sensitive. When it's all said and done, if it's not somebody who is of value in your life or somebody that you value, why would their opinions value, good or bad? Like, we get so caught up and think that everybody's ideas are solidified or some kind of judgment on our character, but it's just their opinions. Like, it's not something to hold on to so deeply. So understand that. But anyway, all the best. I'll catch you on the next one.